right, guys, what is going on? Zay101 here, and we are back with more Tales from Berseria. And I think this episode is the only episode I've started that I didn't have an explanation ring for. But that's not what it's about, guys. So we finally found our destination. It's been such a while since we've been here.
Inomi not somewhere in the sky. In the sky? Wait, look!
Will be a pain and a joy at the same time. It being a pain because I really love this game. It's definitely a great game. I'm definitely gonna play this game off camera. Try to get the platinum game. Try to get the platinum trophy.
I can fight too.
Oh wow, they leveled up with her.
Not even worth my time.
We just got that much experience for that easy battle? Damn. Wow, that battle was so easy.
You're the ones who liberated us from Inominat's domain, right? I want to thank you for all that you've done.
You really don't have to do that. I was just acting in my own interests. If any Molochims still get in my way, I won't hesitate to devour them.
Hey, hold up! Most of us are under the influence of Inominat's power and have been robbed of our free will.
The majority of Molochim are too afraid of malevolence to even go near humans. Before Inominat's interference, we were a peaceful people.
That doesn't matter to me.
We get what you're saying. But if we go easy on anybody, then we'll be the ones who get killed. If you truly want to protect your friends, you'll have to stop us by force.
Wouldn't you agree that having free will means choosing the path you believe in?
I suppose you're right. And that's why we too will work toward the future we desire.
In order to achieve a perfect fusion of human and Moloch power, the Abbey gave Armadi a physical form. Specifically, their vessels embedded with a formula that can manipulate mana. They call these objects divine artifacts.
Is that what that bow is?
Yes, this is one of the divine artifacts. We've decided we want to pass on the knowledge behind the divine artifacts and armatization to future generations.
Why would you want to do that? Armatization is dangerous.
We want to enable humans and Molochim to coexist.
What?
In its current form, armatization is a one-sided process, allowing a human to exploit a Moloch's power. But imagine if humans and Molochim could armatize with mutual awareness and consent.
It could provide just the edge our people need to battle the great forces who seek to harm our world.
Like the Lord of Calamity, you mean? Well, do what you want.
It's another potential for the future.
Yes.
But I have one warning for you. The divine artifact intended for Inominat is already complete. You know what that means, don't you?
Artorias himself will use the divine artifact to armatize with Inominat.
For the good of the future, we'll pray for your success in battle, Lord of Calamity.
That boy gonna be broke. Well.
Show you the beauty of my
spirit! Busted! funny, that last battle was actually much harder than the battle we just had. And that battle just gave us like, what, 7,000 or 8,000 in experience? I was like, whoa. That battle we just had was kind of harder. I wouldn't say harder, like they were more resilient. But we got less experience for that battle. I still can't help but to think about, what chapter was that in World of Final Fantasy? It was a big bridge, just like this. What is that up there? Oh yeah, remember?
Okay. Well, it's nice that we've tracked down an Ominot, but now what's the plan?
I don't think even Griffin could get us up there.
And my guardian takes one passenger only.
I don't think we need to worry about that.
Huh?
Well, looky there. A teleportation art. Looks like we are expected.
For Enomina to fully awaken, they need me and Lafayette. Which means they want to settle this once and for all, too.
Sounds good to me. Bring it on!
Is what reckless idiots say before plunging into the unknown. Be more cautious.
Sorry.
Bruh.
That is the first time I've ever heard Mogilu say something sensible.
A bad omen. Let's be careful and take a good look around first.
Belittling a faithful ally right before the final showdown? Do you not cry? If I prick you, do you not bleed?
Oh yeah, this is definitely it, guys. Everybody got stuff to say? The enemy won't be pulling any tricks at this point. Time to dive in and get busy. Took a look brief look around and didn't find any traps or any oddities. I stopped it alright, but there's no way of knowing what'll happen. Until you just jump in. I should have just gone off. That thing on the dais is the gate of travel. I mentioned Malik already used the teleportation. The transportation, I should say. So let's save the game just in case some shit goes wrong. Oh, would you look at that? Oh my god, are you serious? Well, she takes one of them away. That's a pretty dope room I have to see. Just wanted to see it again. And blame for that. Alright. Oh yeah, we didn't talk about this. I can feel him. The Nominite is just beyond this art. Oh, let's get it.
No exorcists here, it looks like.
But a whole lot of Malakim.
These Malakim are the sublords who have pacts directly with Enominat.
Bruh, all of that is mysterious. He's likely given them a share of his power.
In other words, trouble.
Not at all. We'll just whip out our knives and carve a path.
So like I said a couple of episodes before,
our path now leads to the Empyrean Enominat and Artorias. What a strange feeling.
Yeah, it's not every day you make an enemy of the entire world and head out to cut down a god.
That is certainly true. But what surprises me more is the passion that fills me.
Yeah, you're leaps and bounds more stubborn and willful than any of us.
I'll take that as a compliment.
If you weren't, I don't think you'd have been able to make a pact with Lafayette.
It's because of you, Eleanor, that I've been able to take this voyage around the world. You have my thanks.
I also wish to offer my thanks.
And look at you, kiddo. Despite the unfortunate company you've chosen to keep, you've managed to grow into a fine young man. Good on you.
It's true, isn't it? It kind of makes me want to give myself a pat on the back.
You said it, kid.
Velvet gave me a name, and Eleanor became my vessel. Aizen and Rokuro taught me how to live, and Moggy Lou provided lots of surprises and laughs. All of that made me who I am now. And I'm glad for it.
What about me? Didn't I do something for you?
Get away.
Grimm taught me the ancient tongue. And Bienfu...
No.
Didn't do much.
Thank you. You didn't do jack.
You're me.
Get out of here.
I'm kidding. Bienfu taught me to never be discouraged. I think.
Lafayette, you're so kind!
Well,
seems the enemy's hate for us has galvanized our spirits. We don't know what's ahead. Stay sharp, everyone.
That would have been horrendous. Wait, what is that? I gotta see what that is.
I challenge you.
Bird of Paradise, huh? You ain't like that, did you? Let's
I hope I did a good job.
Boy, you leveled up. Of course you did a good job. He was, and he said that when he levels up. That's, I think that's awesome. Oh my god, if we get into a fight like this. What does this do? We need to do that. Alright, we might be in trouble here, folks. Oh my god! Oh no!
Always be on guard!
No remorse. No weakness. She levels up. Wow, disintegrated. That's what the hell you are, girl. She be wrecking. I love how offensively she can really is. She's really fast when she starts running. Ooh, it's one of these things, huh? It's like a, what should I say? We're caught. At least that's what I thought. Oh no. So it's one of these things. We might be caught. Wait, what? I don't know where you're down there. Oh. Well, never mind. Get away from me. Okay, so we definitely need to activate that. How do we get over there? So far away. Too bad I can't use my board right now. Ooh, there's more than one. Oh, this is never gonna be hard. This definitely final dungeon, I should say. Music is pretty. Ooh, he just flew straight past me. Oh man, he's gonna get us. Hey, let's go. I didn't think I'd be able to jump. Shot your way down there. Oh, there it is. No. Amber jewel obtained from Enomina exudes extremely powerful mana. But is that something we can use or what? I bet we're gonna need like 4 of those, you know, for the end of the game to occur. It's gonna be an orange one, a blue one, a green one, and a red one. I'm sure about that. Oh shit, we're gonna get caught. We're gonna get caught. We're gonna get caught. Oh my god, we're gonna get caught. Oh my god, oh! Eleanor running like she yeah, she got bills to pay. Alright, before we do that, oh no, we definitely need to do this. We definitely need to do this. That'll activate something that's not activated. I don't know exactly where that one is, but hopefully it has correlation with this one. Alright, this warp point can now be used. Oh, wait a minute. I mean, that's where it came from, right? Oh no, don't let that happen. Oh, somebody's on my side. Okay, so this is where we came from, right? Yeah, so you know where we gotta go somewhere else. Oh, what about that one over there? It wasn't normally open, I don't think. How my geowarp will come in handy at this moment. So yeah, this is gonna be a pretty long episode. This could be it. This could be it, guys. Oh yeah, we're done. We're done. Oh! Yep. I knew it! Oh no, he's paralyzed. Oh my goodness. Oh my god. Yeah, this is gonna be tough. This is gonna be tough. Oh, Eisentag is out there, huh? Ooh, that's what we needed. Oh my god. Eleanor! Eleanor gave me that opening I needed. Eleanor, you're smart. You're loyal. I appreciate that. Wow. Where am I on the map? Oh. Okay, damn. Didn't even see where I was. Alright, so looks like I see where we need to go. Oh, no, no, no! Get away from me, get away from me, get away from me, get away from me. Ow! Okay. They baked me out, they baked me out, they baked me out like some oven baked lays. They baked me out. So what is open this time? Interesting. Alright. That's one of those orbs, isn't it? That one looks like it's red, too. See, I told you. A red jewel obtained from me, number 9. So, like I said, it looks like we're gonna get all four before we get there, and those are gonna be used to, I don't know, maybe keep Velvet from dying. I don't know. I'm just feeling some shit out here now, but I just feel like that's what's gonna happen. Oh, there are lights. I had no idea. Something is written upon a model. To the one possessing the spirit orb of the soaring trees, trust in its power and deliver it hence. Fierce are the paths, but seal chamber shall. Okay, so now it looks like we need the green orb to come here. And our all way behind this. I think we can get past. So we definitely need the green orb. Okay, so it looked like it just brought us back to like where. Ooh, look what's open now. Don't catch me, don't catch me. The one that's in the center is open now, and it wasn't before. So let's definitely check that out. No, no. Get away from me. Oh my god, just look at how high the elevation is. I'm pretty sure there's more than that thing is so fast! Get away from me! I hate that little fly thing. It's too fast for its own good. So this is the one that opened up. Whoa. I'm gonna go to the other side of that angle again. On scrap. Alright.
Don't waste my time.
No way. Wait, what? Something's invisible? Oh,
our scout ship has returned.
All right.
Well, well.
How do you like that?
Now here's a fine haul.
Eye of meat and mushroom spore, tender parts of prickle bore.
Tipo Island. Did I see that right? Yo.
Scout ship departing.
Oh man, I know what this means, but where is he? Where in the world?
But boy, such an odd thing to hang in the sky. Wasn't Innominaut's vessel supposed to be the Earth?
Well, stereotypically at least, gods tend to have a penchant for high places. Gods and other things.
And other things? You mean birds?
I'm talking about people like you.
Birds. Birds fly because they must. Luffy said that a long time ago. That must be the answer Artorias was looking for. And yet, is it my answer?
Oh. Wow. Look at how high up we are. And how round the world is. So, the world is round.
How did you not know that already? The horizon at sea has always been curved like this.
Right. That's why you always see the masthead of an approaching ship first when it comes over the horizon.
Give you to a sight like this and you're still unimpressed.
And you're gawking at the sights in our enemy's lair.
The energy's in this place.
I just said
yes.
About
it's just as I'd expected.
What is?
I know what this temple is made of. It's crystallized energy drawn and condensed from the Earth Pulse by Innominaut himself.
Oh.
To put it another way, this place is the Imperium Innominaut's body.
You mean, we just dove straight into Innominaut's belly?
If you knew that, then why...
I warned you, didn't I? Now quit making such a racket in the enemy's lair.
You're right. Actually, it's not that different from the Earth Pulse when you think about it. Besides, if we want to defeat Innominaut, then coming in here is our only option, no matter how tremendous his power. If we can destroy his heart, he can be killed.
Yep. But in this case, the heart is Innominaut's true body and Shepherd Artorias himself. We might be the ones who get destroyed.
This is not news, Magilu. It's too late to get scared now.
All right. Scared and leave. Yeah, I was just saying how high up you are. I didn't even see anything. so to avoid making this any longer than what it should be, I'm gonna actually put the gameplay here, and when we come back, we'll continue through the layer of Innominosh. Until then, guys, I will catch you guys later.